What's up internet, I am Manish from DripValianWriter.com and I am back again with another awesome Python tutorial. Today's tutorial is all about Python string replace method. So without further ado, let's start. But before that, please don't leave without pressing that thumbs up button if you like this video. Also, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, as this year I am aiming for 1 lakh subscribers. Now let's start. So what is Python string replace method? As the name suggests, replace is a built-in string method which replaces one pattern from another and returns a new string as a result. What I mean by new string, I'll explain to you in the end of this video. Right on your screen is the syntax of a string method replace. Similar to other string methods which we have discussed so far, this also accepts three arguments. Let's see what those are. Old underscore str. The first argument is the old string. This is the string which you want to replace. This could be a single character or a multi-character string. New underscore str. The second argument is a new string. This is a string that will replace the old one. Instance. This argument indicates number of instances of old string which will get replaced by the new one. Among three, this is the only integer argument. Among all the arguments, only instance is the one that is optional. Rest of them are mandatory. In case if you do not specify the last argument, then by default, all the instances of the old string will get replaced by the new one. Okay, now that we have learned the syntax, let's do some examples of Python string replace method. In order to perform any example, we first need a base string over which we will run our string method replace. So for today's demonstration, our base string will be I love pizza. Pizza is my guilty pleasure. I believe pizza doesn't have calories. Pizza should be declared as king of foods. Yes, today we will use a multi-line string. In case you don't know how to deal with multi-line strings in Python, then check out my Python tutorial 9. You can find the link in the description. Now, let's do our first example. Here, I have saved our multi-line string into a variable using triple quotes. Don't worry, I have discussed the concept of triple quotes also in the Python tutorial 9, which I mentioned earlier. Now say, you were a big fan of pizza when you wrote this message. But now you realize that fudge cake is much better than pizza. So you decided to modify this message. Let's see how we can do this using a string method replace. By the way, comment and let me know which one you prefer more, a pizza or a fudge cake. I'm a big fan of pizza. Anyways, let's write the code. We use the string object base underscore str, which is the variable holding our base string, to call the replace method. Using this method, we are trying to replace the string pizza with fudge cake. In this function call, pizza is the old string, which will get replaced by the new string, which in this case is fudge cake. As we saw in the previous tutorial that, a direct function call doesn't show the result in editors like the one I'm using. Thus, to see the result, we need to do a little bit of workaround. So we have two ways for that. First one is to place this entire function call into a print statement. And the second one is to declare a variable and store the result produced by this function call and then use that variable to print the output. We have already seen the first approach, which is why today we will go with the second one. So let's declare the variable. Here I have declared a variable result. Now I'm going to cut this method call from here. And assigned it to this variable. Done. Next, we simply have to print the value stored in this variable. For that, we will use our trusted print statement. That's it. Now let's execute and see the result. As you can see that all the instances of pizza have been replaced with fudge cake. In this example, we did not use the third parameter, and because of that, all the instances of pizza got replaced with fudge cake. Now let's say you only want to modify the first three instances of pizza with fudge cake. In that case, we simply have to add 3 as the value of our third parameter in the method call. So let's modify the function call and add 3 into it. Now on execution, only the first 3 instances of the string pizza will get replaced with fudge cake. Let's check. Now if you see the output, you will find that except from the first 3 instances of pizza, nothing has changed. See, we still have pizza in our fourth sentence here. That's how we use Python string replace method. Learning how to call a method is easy, but learning how the method call works is worth the penny, as this could help you in your interview and in solving various errors. So let's do that. If you remember, earlier I said that the replace method returns a new string as a result. The question here is, why a new string? You will get the answer to this question in the explanation of how the method call works. When you call a string method replace, it takes the base string, then it creates a copy of it. While creating that new copy, the interpreter substitutes the old string with the new string that you have specified during the method call. Once the process of replacing the old string with the new one is done, then Python interpreter shows the modified copy of the base string as the output to the user. In this whole process, the original base string remains the same. It is because in Python, inbuilt objects like strings are immutable, which means once they are created, they cannot be changed. They will remain the same as they were created. Any attempt to change will result in an error. That is how and why string method replace returns a new string as a result. If you find this explanation awesome, then hit the thumbs up button and share this video with your friends on social media. Most importantly, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. That is the tutorial on Python string replace method. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionWriter.com.